Hello children, today we are going to start with geography chapter 2, that is abiotic resources, land, soil and water. In previous chapter we have studied about abiotic resources. Abiotic resources comprises of all the non-living things like land, air, water, soil, minerals, rocks, metals, and among all these abiotic resources, land, soil and water are the most important land resources. Land resources are even the source of economic wealth of a country. The wealth of a country depends on the quantity and quality of its resources. Land resources even influence the climate of a place. For example, the land surface on mountains does not support human settlement. And on the other hand, in plains areas and river valleys, we have thick human settlement because these areas are suitable for the cultivation of crops. So we can say that land, soil and water form an important part of our life because it even helps in the sustenance of life of plants, animals and human beings. So let us discuss about these three resources in detail. So first of all, before starting, you should know that what are land resources. Land resources basically refers to the type of land, its shape and its form. When we talk about land resources, it consists of the different land forms like mountains, plains, plateaus, deserts, river valleys. These are the different type of land resources. Land resources provide shelter to both animals and plants and even all the living organisms. When we talk about land resources, these are helpful in satisfying the human needs. Almost 30% of the earth's surface is covered with land resources. And when we talk about the human settlements, 90% of the population of the total world is occupying only 30% of the land area. So in this manner we can say that a very small part of land area is being consumed for the human settlements. Even all parts of the land area are not equally habitable. It means that the density of population varies as per different areas. As we have discussed earlier, that mountains, the places which are extremely hot or extremely cold, marshy areas, thick forest, these areas are not suitable for human settlements. And on the other hand, river valleys, plains areas and even grasslands, these are suitable for human settlement. So we can say that all the land areas are not equally habitable or the population is different as per the areas. So when we say that the density of population is different in different areas, so there are certain factors which affect the density of population. These factors are fertility of soil, availability of water, landform, natural resources, climate, etc. These are the features that affect the human settlement in a particular area. The areas which are having suitable features attract more people and there the population is more. On the other hand, the places which are not having suitable climate or suitable conditions, there the population is less. So moving ahead with the chapter, now we'll be discussing about land use. Land is used in different manner. So here land use means the manner in which the land is used for various activities like agriculture, forestry, mining, building houses or different type of settlements. So this is basically termed as land use. Now we'll be discussing about types of land. As per the ownership of land, the land is classified into two types: community land and private land. So now we'll be discussing about these two types of land. First of all, we'll discuss about private land. The land which is owned by an individual is termed as private land, and that land is basically used only by that person and its family members. This land is basically used for personal use. Next, we'll be discussing about community land. Community land is the land area which is owned by a group of people or by a particular community. This type of land is even termed as common property resource. Community land is basically for the purpose of collection of herbs, medicinal herbs, gum, nuts, forest products, etc. All the countries in the world are having different ratios of private land and community land as per the need of the people. Or we can say, all the countries in the world are having both the types of land, community land and private land. Now we are going to discuss about land use pattern. Land use pattern refers to the activities in which the land is used. As per the needs of the nations, there is difference in the land use pattern of every country. When we talk about land use pattern, land is used for various purposes, like forestry, agriculture, growing crops, for pastures. So these are various activities for which the land is used as per the need of the people. Example of land use pattern, like in India, we are having more land as crop land, and on the other hand, Australia is having more land for pastures. So in the same manner, there are different land use pattern as per the countries. Now we are going to study about the factors which are affecting the land use. Right now we have discussed that the land use pattern is different as per the country and it is highly uneven. So the factors which are affecting the land use pattern of a country are climate, topography, types of soil, availability of water, minerals, technology and human resources. So now we are going to discuss about these factors in detail. First of all, we are going to discuss about climate. Climate plays a very important role in the land use pattern. As you all know, our earth is divided into three heat zones. So we can say that the equatorial regions and the polar regions, which are either extremely hot or extremely cold, it is very difficult to use the land for pastures or as crop land in these regions. While on the other hand, the places or the zones which are having moderate climate, they support the land use pattern, or they support the land for the growth of crops and for pastures. In the regions having extreme climate, only tiny grasses and shrubs are growing. And on the other hand, in the areas which are having moderate climate, the land is fertile and it supports the growth of different types of crops. Next factor is topography. Topography refers to the shape and land features. When we talk about topography, the plains area which are having fertile land and suitable conditions are more appropriate for the growth of crops, and it supports the cropland and the land for pastures. On the other hand, the mountainous region and the desert region, this does not support the growth of different types of crops. And even the plains area, as it is having suitable landform, it attracts more number of people for settlement. Next feature is types of soil. As we all know, soil is a very important factor for the growth of plants or crops. So the areas which are having fertile soil, they support the growth of different types of crops as they are fertile. And on the other hand, the hot and cold deserts, which is having infertile soil, they does not support the growth of different types of crops or pastures. So in this manner, type of soil also affects the growth of crops and it acts as a factor for the land use pattern. Next factor is availability of water. As you all know, that water is an important part of our life. All the living organisms need water to survive. So water is equally important for human life as well as for land use pattern. The areas which are having availability of water are more prone to the cultivation of crops. And on the other hand, desert areas which are not having adequate supply of water, they are not suitable for growing different types of crops. Only tiny shrubs are grown in these areas. So for a well-developed and planned land use pattern, water is very important. Next factor for proper land use pattern is our minerals. Minerals even affect the land use pattern. We can understand it through an example. As you all know, minerals are found under the surface of earth. So things which are rich in minerals are used for mining purpose, and even different industries can be set up near to that area for utilizing that resource. And on the other hand, the areas which are not rich in minerals, they are not developed because no industries can be set up in those areas. So we can say that the areas which are rich in minerals are suitable for industrial growth, as it provides an occupation to the people too. So it helps in proper land use pattern. Next factor is technology and human resource. As we have studied in previous chapter, technology and human resource are interrelated. They both are two sides of a same coin. As we know that human resources are very important to convert the raw materials into finished products, and that can be done only with the help of technology. So both technology and human resource play an important part for proper land use pattern, because technology and human resources both are dependent. Humans can convert various resources into usable products to fulfill their need by the help of technology. Now we are going to study about usefulness of land resources. As we are discussing it since the starting of the chapter, that land resources are very important for the survival of human life. So we are going to discuss about some uses of these land resources. So the various uses of land resources are: land resources or land provides rich farming grounds. Land is even a storehouse of minerals. When we talk about the forest land, it helps us in providing timber, medicinal herbs, gum, resin and other forest produces. Land resources acts as a shelter for all the living organisms, especially animals and plants. Land resources are used as places for tourist destination, or we can say that it encourages tourism. Land resources even provides us with various types of landforms like mountains, plains, plateaus, deserts, valleys, etc. Land is equally used for both personal and professional use. So as we have discussed that land is very important for us, but people are continuously misusing and overusing these land resources. As the people are developing nowadays, so their needs are increasing. They are continuously using land for setting up industries, for building houses and for other commercial purposes. So in this manner, the land is being degraded, or we can say the area which is under land resources is getting reduced day by day. The misuse and overuse of land resources by human beings is resulting in degradation of land. When we talk about degradation of land, it is resulting in landslides, soil erosion and even desertification, because continuously the forest area is being reduced and more land is converted into a flat land for different construction purposes. So if we want to stop the degradation of land, it is very important to conserve our land so that these land resources can be made available for the future generations and even present generation can also utilize it to have a proper living. So now we are going to discuss about conservation of land and the ways to conserve. Conservation of land resources means the proper management and careful use of these resources so that these resources can be made available for future. Availability of land resources for future is equally important for the survival of human life. So it is very important to conserve our resources for future, otherwise our future generations will not be able to utilize these resources, as the survival of human beings depend on the availability of these resources. So there are certain ways to conserve our land resources. So these ways are, first is more and more trees should be grown. Overgrazing on the land should be stopped. Degradation of land should be checked. Chemical fertilizers and pesticides should be used in a controlled manner. Biofertilizers use should be increased so that the land can be made more productive. So these are certain ways to conserve our land resources. So till now we have discussed about land resources, land use patterns, land use, conservation of resources and the factors affecting the land use pattern. So with this we are going to wind up today's class, and in the next class we'll be discussing about the other two abiotic factors, which are soil and water. So before winding up the class today, let us discuss about some of the important points related to what we have studied today. Abiotic resources consist of non-living things like minerals, rocks, metals, land, soil and water. Land resources refers to the shape, form and nature of the land surface. On the basis of ownership, land can be classified as private and community land. Climate, topography, types of soil, availability of water, minerals and technology and human activities are the main factors that affect the land use pattern. So this was about land resources, and in the next class we'll be studying about soil resources. So with this, goodbye for now. Stay home, stay safe.